Colombian authorities extradited Dominican drug lord Cesar Peralta, who was also known as El Abusador, the Abuser. Colombian authorities extradited him to the United States, essentially to face different types of drug trafficking charges filed in the District of Puerto Rico. It is quite important to say that we're talking about a major case, since Peralta is currently one of the biggest drug kingpins in the Caribbean. Because we need to remember that even when drug trafficking has been located almost exclusively in South America and Mexico, there are other nations in this part of the world, in this region of the world, where drug trafficking has been gaining a lot of power and a lot of influence. And one of these nations, unfortunately, is the Dominican Republic, to the point where we're talking about one of the biggest drug lords in the whole world, and someone who is from the Dominican Republic and started to operate in the Dominican Republic. We need to remember that Peralta was the leader of a transnational criminal organization that was based in the Dominican Republic specifically. This organization essentially moved tons, multi-tons of shipments of cocaine from Colombia and Venezuela, and transported this cocaine not only to Puerto Rico, but especially to the United States of America. So this situation was actually quite controversial, because the arrest and this order of extradition against Peralta essentially revealed what many people have been claiming for a long time, which was the fact that Venezuela was deeply involved in drug trafficking, especially the socialist regime of Nicolás Maduro. I mean, there has been many confirmations over the last few years, but this situation with Peralta is essentially another confirmation of this particular manner. So, while this is definitely good news, it's always good news that authorities in Latin America arrest and detain these type of criminals. If you want me to be completely honest, the truth is that it is quite possible that this case won't do anything. This case won't change anything, because over the last few decades, we have seen the way drug trafficking in Latin America never stops when you detain or kill the leader. I mean, in drug trafficking, this phrase that you kill the snake by the head, it doesn't work like that. It simply doesn't work like that. And if you want me to give you an example, we can talk basically about Pablo Escobar. I mean, we are here in Medellin. Pablo Escobar was essentially the most famous drug lord in history. And Colombian authorities, along with American authorities, managed to kill this guy, to kill this criminal. And what happened? Anything changed, actually. I mean, drug trafficking continued here in Colombia. Or we can also talk about the Mexican case with El Chapo Guzman. Mexican authorities, along with US authorities, managed to catch Chapo Guzman. And what happened? Nothing changed in Mexico. Mexico remained one of the biggest drug trafficking nations all around the world. So one of the main reasons why this is such a horrible reality is essentially the fact that there has been a pretty deep tie, a pretty deep link between drug cartels and criminals organization with Latin American governments. Unfortunately, it's like that. It has always been like that, because it explains this invulnerable nature of drug organization, of drug cartels, the fact that you can dismantle the whole organization, the fact that you can kill or arrest the leader and nothing happens. And the only thing, or at least one of the biggest things that explains this situation, is essentially the tie between drug cartels and the governments in these countries, governments of Latin America. Reporting from Medellin, Colombia, Luis Orozco, Newsweek.